Ms. Thaler, you have a right to speak this morning if you'd like. You don't have any obligation to speak, but if you'd like to choose to speak, now is the time to do it.
Yes, I would like to say something.
Go ahead.
I'm innocent. Fuck you all. You're garbage.
That's all you're on.
Thank you, Ms. Thaler. I don't know that that's appropriate here.
Sorry, I told you what somebody else can.
What I would say is, the worst thing that seems to happen to parents is to lose their child. It's worse, though, when you don't lose your child to something like cancer or an accident. It's when someone takes that child from the world. What I can't imagine, nobody can imagine, is when the person that takes a child from the world is the one that brought that child in. But that is what the jury concluded you did, and I respect the jury's judgment, and I respect Minnesota's decision about what the appropriate consequence is. Nothing I do would bring justice to this situation. Nothing I do would relieve any of the pain that you caused by doing that. But what is, according to law, the just and fair sentence for what you did is what Mr. Allard said, and that is life in prison without the possibility of parole. So I will judge you guilty of first degree murder and issue that sentence. I will not impose any sentence.
I can't hear you over your stomach grumbling. I'm sorry.
Bottom line is that you are being sentenced to life in prison without the possibility of parole, Ms. Thaler. I'm not going to impose any kind of fine or fees. I will require that you submit a DNA sample. As I mentioned, I'll keep restitution open for 60 days. There's a tagging misdemeanor case. I'm going to dismiss that in the interest of justice. With that, is there anything else, Mr. Allard, you can cover this morning?
No, Your Honor, thank you.
Ms. Rapp, I'll give you the opportunity as well. Anything else?
No, thank you, Your Honor.
Mr. Leary?
Nothing, Your Honor.
Ms. Newton?
Nothing, Your Honor.
Okay, thank you, everyone, for your hard work in this case.